Well, right now I've got Matt Rooney on the phone. Matt, you are the editor of the Save Jersey blog, and you are a divorce attorney. Thanks for coming on New Jersey 101.5. How you doing, Matt?
Every single one of my days is interesting.
I was going to say, you know, between politics and you know, marital disruption, you are a busy man.
Well, that's what it is, and the marital disruption is great training for New Jersey politics.
That I'm sure. Now, listen, I went on a whole thing yesterday, Matt, and I'm going to run out of time before the break between traffic and weather, so I'm going to ask you before we even get to that to just hang with me because I want to flesh out some things with you. And the first is that I went on a whole tirade yesterday about the gas tax, saying that it is unconscionable that the Republican Party, as the opposition party, could not mount a serious offense to the incumbent majority party based on the single issue of the gas tax, where 70% of New Jerseyans oppose it, even when faced with the knowledge of, roads that are falling apart. New Jerseyans don't want to be taxed anymore because they don't trust their government with their money. How did the Republicans fail so miserably? And it looks like that failure is going to get even worse when the absentee ballots and the recount happen in the 16th district. What happened, Matt?
Yeah, look, I mean, what happened could easily fill up an entire show. Yeah. I've made an entire blog, SaveJersey.com, out of what's wrong with not just the state, but also the Republican Party. Look, at the end of the day, no matter how good your message is, if you're getting outspent 5-1, 6-1, 7-1, as was the case in many of these districts because the public sector unions were pumping in money, it doesn't matter how good your message is.
Yeah.
It's not going to get to the voter. But you're absolutely right, Bill. Ronald Reagan, a long time ago, said that voters respond to bold colors, not pale pastels. That wasn't just an ideological point. That was great campaign advice. And something like opposition to the gas tax, which you have been very correct to advocate, something Republicans should have campaigned on, creates a clear contrast. When you just say, hey, listen, the other side is not managing your money well, we're going to do a better job, that's you auditioning to be a financial advisor. That's not something that makes the voter say, you know what, these guys in Trenton, they're really doing a terrible job, but these guys are giving me a reason to give them a shot.
You know, it sounded as poor a message as the new Jeb Bush message of Jeb will fix it. What the heck are you talking about? Like, what does that even mean? To the average voter, we respond to reality. And the reality is that the current leadership in Trenton is going to raise your gas tax. And whether they compromise on an estate tax or anything else, it doesn't matter. Your costs every day in this state are going to go up. So I want to focus on the 16th district. I was not overly surprised at the results in the 11th district. Now, Mary Pat Angelini, I think she's a great legislator, as do I think Caroline Casagrande. Two really experienced, thoughtful leaders in the assembly. I think it's a disappointment that they're not going to be returning because I think their common sense was appreciated in Trenton. But they lost. And, you know, nothing you can do about that. That was just a surge. And for whatever happened, you know, negative ads work. But in the 16th district, I think people are really surprised. And here's my question to you. Republicans have been blaming the map. They've been blaming Governor Christie. And they got so to the point where they were so arrogant that they moved Princeton into the 16th district, figuring they will essentially isolate all those Democratic votes in Princeton. Talk about something coming back to bite you. The turnout yesterday, when my wife and I voted yesterday in the afternoon, it was surging. I was shocked. I was like voter almost 200. So, Matt, what do you think? Is that what happened?
Yeah, and I think only about 205 people voted in the entire state. So that doesn't tell you what part.
It was all in Princeton.
Yeah, look, I mean, I think that what happened yesterday in 16 and elsewhere is a symptom of a larger problem. And it's a strategy that Republicans have gotten in trouble with outside of New Jersey, too. And it's that, well, if we just narrow down the battlefield enough, not just geographically, but also on the issues, it'll make it easier to hold on to what we got. And that's ridiculous. You can't look at the map that way. You have to constantly be proactive and look for new opportunities.
Yeah.
And you can't assume your enemy is only going to attack you where they say they're going to attack you. So when all that late money came in, we know the NJEA dumped in about an extra $750,000 around Halloween heading into the final push. They caught all of these candidates off guard. So whether Princeton was in there or not, in a district that's always kind of close, that's a lot of money. And guess what? To make my point even further, I like Donna Simon and Jack Cittarelli a lot, but Jack Cittarelli's tried to work with the NJEA.
Yep,
That's and they right. still took a shot at him.
Well, why was he surprised? And you know, and let's talk about Jack for a minute. Now, Jack's a guy that he's got a healthy political ego, you know, and there are all these rumors he wants to run for governor. How badly does it hurt a guy that wants to run for governor that A, tried to work across the aisle, literally with the group that is the nemesis of all Republican principles, and many people, especially with you given the governor's two big victories running for his first election and then reelection, for him to try to work with that group could hurt him, and then to only win by a couple hundred votes, if he holds on at all. How does that hurt him when he wants to run up?
I mean, look, it certainly doesn't help. But, Bill, so often I feel as if you and I were hit on a rock, and everybody else was hit on the head with a rock, and they all had amnesia, and they forget 2009, and nobody remembers it except for you and I.
Yeah.
I remember Governor Christie running uphill against John Corzine in this state, where the Democrats have a huge voter registration advantage.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yep.
Getting outgunned severely with money. And going directly at these people, not trying to work with them, trying
That's
to
right.
defeat them. He skipped the NGA's invitation to come and address
exactly.
their membership.
You know what? The entirety of the Republican leadership needs to be reevaluated. And I'm friends with John Bramnick. I think John had his heart in the right place. I think, unfortunately, you know, when you compromise too much before you even sit at the table, you've given away any opportunity to have the moral high ground on taxes. People in the state, you know, it's not about party. Because we'll go either way. We've had a tax revolt. It's about common sense. It's about who speaks for us. And unfortunately, the challengers and many of the incumbents did not speak for their constituents, and the results showed it. All right, Matt, I got to get out of here for news, but thanks for calling New Jersey 101.5. I always appreciate your perspective. You and I will be in touch and talking very soon, I'm sure.